chapter, verse 51, and it reads like this. And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom, and the earth did quake, and the rocks rent. My thought for tonight is God pulled down the curtain so we could see. I want to get y'all up to where we at like this. The Bible declares that Jesus will come out of the lineage of David, Samuel. We know that the Bible is plain and specific in the fact that Jesus Christ was before the very foundation of the world. We know that Jesus was before the earth was ever formed and made in its fashion that it was made. Because John declares everything that was made by him and for him. I believe when everything was made in the book of Genesis, whenever God made the grass of the field and the herbs, all the things that fly, creep, swim, and crawl, I believe that Jesus was there, the Son of God. I believe when he made man, Jesus was there because God said, let us make man in our image. Amen. We know tonight that there's three that make up the Godhead. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Praise God. So I believe tonight, amen, that he was there when God reached down and scratched out the many things that he scratched out, all the oceans and all the things that was made, all the waters that was made, and the land, amen, that was made. And when God put a firmament around the earth, amen, and made gravity and put this great creation that he'd done, he put it on an axis and he reached out into the heavens and he grabbed a star and he pulled it just a little closer to that creation that he called earth so that it would warm man and there would be seasons that the things that he created would grow and die and grow and die and begin. Amen, that man would be able to prosper and he would be able to plant things and grow things. I believe that he was there when the Garden of Eden was established and everything was perfect. I believe that he was there when the Father came down and walked in the cool of the day with the man that he created out, and Eve, the woman that was created from the man. Praise God. And I believe, amen, if we'll look into the Bible, starting around somewhere around the 53rd chapter of Isaiah, we'll see that in the 53rd chapter of Isaiah, you ain't got to turn there. I'm just trying to get you up to where we're going to be reading that tonight. In the 27th chapter, amen, the man of God Isaiah said, behold, who has believed our report? Amen, he says in the scriptures, amen, that he'll grow up before us, a tender plant. Amen, and then root out of dry ground, and he has no form of comeliness. We know that Jesus Christ came into this world born of a virgin. Amen. You can read in the 26th chapter of the book of Matthew, it said, and on this wise, amen, Jesus was born. Amen. That a woman was picked out, and we know that her name was Mary. The Bible don't say much about Mary's worship or anything about her, but we know tonight that, amen, she must have been, amen, a woman of God, amen, for God to look down upon her, amen, and know that he could trust her, amen, with such a great, amen, thing, amen, and he overshadowed her, amen, and began, amen, to form something in her womb that, amen, that was of God, amen, not of any kind of man-made lust or anything, but it was of God, amen, that he was sending a promise, amen, out of the stump of Jesse, the root of David, amen, the Messiah that was to come, amen, and he began to form this creation in the womb, amen. How many of you know that, amen, that God begins life in the womb? Come on now, amen. Talking about abortion, amen. It's not a life until it reaches this age or that age. Let me tell you something. Amen. It is a life. Amen. When it begins. Amen. To take on the form in the very, 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 very first stages. At the very first moments. Amen. That the great cataclysm. Amen. That takes place in the womb. Amen. And it becomes a living. Amen. Breathing. Amen. Apparatus. Amen. Of the human body. What I'm trying to say is tonight. Amen. That whenever that baby. Amen. Is created in the womb from the very, very beginning. It is a life. It is a child. Amen. And we have no right to kill.
Amen.
Amen. Jesus Christ. Amen. He was going to be despised and rejected of men. Amen. As the Bible goes on to say in the 53rd chapter.
Amen. That praise God that he has been, surely he was borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. And we did esteem him stricken. Amen. We know tonight that praise God, Jesus Christ. Amen. He came into this world. Amen. And y'all know, amen, that Mary was pregnant. Amen. Or amen. Or impregnated, amen, by the Holy Spirit of God. Amen. And she was espoused to a man to marry. Amen. And she had never, him and this man, her and this man had never, amen, come together to know one another. Amen. In the way, amen, that a child would be created. Amen. But y'all know the story, amen, of the angel of the Lord. Amen. Appeared unto, amen, the man, praise God. Amen. And told him, amen, to fear not. Amen. Because he was going to put away Mary. Y'all know the story. Amen. And he was going to put her away. Amen. Because there she was. Amen. Starting to show. Amen. And he had never even, amen, knew her as a wife. Amen. And there it was. Amen. That creation of God. Amen. It was in the womb. Amen. And God said, amen, that you'll name him, you'll call him Emmanuel. Amen. God with you. I want you to know something tonight, church. Amen. God has showed us many things in the scripture tonight. Amen. He's showing us, amen, amen, about salvation and everything, amen, that God has done for us. Praise God. Go pray for him.
God bless.
Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Dean, would you give me just a little bit more word, please, sir? I appreciate it so much. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. In the 55th chapter of the book of Isaiah, amen, it tells us, amen, everybody can come. And by order, amen, Jesus Christ tells us to come. Amen, all you that are heavy laden and burdened, cast your cares upon me. Amen, for my burden is easy, praise God. Amen, I want you to know something tonight that Jesus Christ, amen, he came down the birth canal just like me and you did. Amen, but the only difference was, amen, that he was God, amen, in the flesh, amen, and he took on the flesh. Amen, he graced, praise God. Amen, he came into this world in the same form and fashion that we did. Amen, but there was no room in the inn. He didn't come in a grandized stature. Amen, but glory to God, he was laid. Amen, after he'd been wrapped in milk rags. Amen, and whatever was in the barn. He was laid in a manger, glory to God. Amen, and God, amen, amen, drew a star, amen, I said the other night. And he pushed it out, amen, and called, amen, the shepherds to come. Amen, and look at the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Amen, but yet he was just a baby. Amen, he had to suck the bottle. Amen, or the breast, amen. Amen, in them days they don't know if they even had a bottle. Amen, but what I'm trying to tell you was, amen, that he was a child. Amen, but there he was. Amen, God, and he grew up. Amen, inside of his mother's, inside of his family. Amen, but glory to God. Amen, God had separated him out. Amen, and made him, amen. Amen, that did Isaiah prophesy. Amen, that thing that we was going to esteem. Amen, to be stricken, glory to God. Amen, and smoked. Amen, that by the stripes of his back. Amen, that he took upon his back. Amen, through the cat of nine tails. Amen, that it was going to be. Amen, for our healing, glory to God. Amen, and now here he is, 12 years old. Amen, teaching, amen, in the synagogues. Amen, with such authority and wisdom. Amen, that even astounded, amen, the scholars of that day. Amen, but glory to God, he kept on growing. Amen, glory to God, God's fixing to show us something. Amen, praise God. Amen, there he comes. Amen, at the age of about 18 years old, maybe 19, into a land of Cana. Amen, and turns the water into wine. He begins, glory to God, amen, to expose the Father, amen, in everything that he does.
Bless him, Lord.
He touches blinded eyes and makes them sleep.
Amen.
Amen. He spits in the ground and rubs it together with some dirt, drops it on a man's eyes, and he sleeps. Amen. He touches a woman's child, amen, and brings him back to life, already dead. He goes in the room, amen, with the family's daughter, amen, and he touches it, amen, and makes him see, amen. You see what I'm talking about? He was with the disciples walking, Amen. And there they come upon a fig tree. Amen. And it's already looks like it ought to have some figs on it. Amen. Maybe it's this time of year. Amen. And whenever we start to see the fig come on the tree. Amen. But when he looked at it, amen, it didn't have no fruit on it. I want you to know something today. Amen. It's going to come a day. Amen. When he's going to look at the tree. And if it ain't got no fruit on it, amen, it's going to be sawed asunder. I want you to know today that the Bible tells me and you, amen, that we must bear fruit. Amen. We must be fruit bearers. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. For a tree that don't have any fruit, amen, you'll begin to say, it ain't even a fruit tree. Amen. But glory to God. If we got the power of Jesus inside of us, we're going to be fruit bearers.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Doing all of these miracles. Telling them all of these things. Amen. Exposing himself. He told them in the synagogues, he said, I and the Father are one. Come on. I do the works of my Father. Amen. I need not a witness of man because, amen, the Father is my witness. Amen. Did the blind see? Amen. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Amen. The blind see and the crippled walk. Amen. The man in the pool of Bethesda for 38 years had laid there. Amen. Not being able to get into the pool. Amen. But the man Jesus came by. Amen. And said, wilt thou be made whole? I want to ask you tonight. Amen. What is our mindset? Amen. Wilt thou be made whole tonight?
Amen.
Amen. He told the disciples, I was born into this world for this cause. Amen. Headed to the cross. Amen. When he went into the Garden of Gethsemane and prayed. Amen. He had them to stay. Amen. And watch. Amen. And watch and pray with me. But when he came back, they was asleep. Amen. But glory to God. I want you to know. Amen. He went back into that garden. And he prayed. Glory to God. Amen. Because he knew what was coming. He knew that there was going to be one that would betray him. Amen. Because he told him the one that kissed me. Amen. Is the one that betrays me. He told him when they was breaking bread together. Amen. The one that dips his bread in my cup. Amen. Him to be the same. I want you to know today. He knew what was coming, glory to God. He knew that he was headed to Calvary. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They came and got him, amen. Judas walked up to him and kissed him on the cheek. Oh, with spears and swords they came. And he said, you come, amen, with spears and swords, but I was just teaching in the synagogues, teaching you about the Father. Amen, and the things to come. Amen. I want you to know something. Amen. He didn't put up a fight, but he went with them willingly.
Why do we put up such a fight?
He went with them willingly. Amen. Carried, amen, and made accusations of them. Amen. He made accusations. They could not find anybody. Amen. Would make an accusation of him. Amen. For blasphemy. Amen. But then when he told them, amen, that he was going to be standing at the right hand of the Father. Amen. It says the high priest, amen, that got up and rent his clothes. Amen. It said, what need have we for witnesses? Amen. He is a blasphemer. Amen. They carried him, amen, to Pontius Pilate. Amen. And Pilate searched him over. Amen. He could find no fault with this man, Jesus. Amen. And he said, amen, to the people, I find no fault. Amen. But they cried out the more. Amen. That he needs to be crucified. Amen. There he was. Amen. There he was. Amen. Can you see him? Amen. Speaking not a word in his defense. Amen. Because you know what? He knew that in 2015 there was going to be a group of people gathered. Amen. In the church beside 32. Amen. It was going to need some redemption. Now, amen. It was going to need some power.
Amen.
So he spoke not a word. Amen. And Pilate, amen. He said, I'll have him scourged. Amen. They carried him back and they mocked him and they spit on him. Amen. And they whipped him. Amen. And they whipped him so bad that the flesh, amen, was literally torn off of the muscle and the muscle off of the bone. Amen. That he could, he was not, amen, as the man of God said, that his visage, amen, which is his countenance or the way he looked, amen, was so marred, amen, that he was not even almost recognized as a man. They had beat him so bad, amen, but they brought him back out, amen, with a known criminal, amen, and said, who shall I release today, amen, on this day of feast? And the crowd cried out,
Amen. Release Barabbas. Amen. Release the sinner. Amen. Over the Lord. Amen. That it came, Lord to God. Amen. To die for my and your sins.
Amen. Now, Pilate said, I wash my hands of this. In the book of Genesis, when God gave the Ten Commandments, in the book of Exodus, when God gave the Ten Commandments, amen, he said, you know what? Amen, them that would have another God, amen, before him, he said, I will visit the iniquity, amen, of them, amen, to the second and to the third generation. Amen. And whenever they accepted the responsibility, amen, of Jesus being crucified, amen, they said that we'll take the blood, amen, of him that is being crucified. This is what the Jews said. Amen. We'll take it. Amen. And we'll not only take it on our generation, amen, but the generation to follow. Amen. So they let him off. Amen. Going to Calvary. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. There he was put on that cross. Amen. The nails drove through his hand and then through his feet. Amen. Lifted up. Amen. Between this old wicked world. Amen. In heaven. I want you to know something. Amen. There he was. A man that knew no sin. Amen. But became sin. That me and you tonight. Glory to God. Amen. We can accept that imputed righteousness. Amen. Amen. Our very own now. Amen. That we'll be able to stand up. Amen. And say glory to God. Amen. I'm redeemed. Amen. 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 Separated. I'm a peculiar people. Glory to God. Amen. Why? Because I've been redeemed. Amen. Now, there he is on the cross, suffering. Theologians say that he was beaten so bad. What happened to him was his body began to fill up with water. His lungs. And as he was on that cross, I want you to get this picture. He was in agony. Nails through his feet, Erica. Just trying to get another breath, he would push up on the nail in his feet, crying out in pain. In agony, just to get another breath as his lungs was filling up. The weight of the water inside of his chest cavity, amen, was compressing his heart, amen, and it got to be a struggle for his heart to even beat. Boom, 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 boom. And he pushed up against the nail in his feet, amen, to take another breath, amen, for you.
Amen.
Come on.
I'll see him there.
With the crowns on his head. Amen. Clad in the thorns. Amen. By the mockers. Amen. And he's suffering. The nails is pulling against his hand. He's pushing up against the nail in his feet in agony. Amen. Just to get another breath. Come on. Struggling. Amen. Sold it tonight. Glory to God. Amen. We would have the freedom. Amen. To come into the house of God. Amen. A place that's consecrated and dedicated. Amen. And set aside. Amen. As a holy sanctuary. Amen. When we come into this place. Amen. Are we able to come? Amen. Because, amen, of all the torture that he took on that cross. Amen. Glory to God. I'm telling you today, church, we ain't hearing the crucifixion preached. Amen. As much as it needs to be preached. We ain't hearing the suffering of our Jesus. Amen. Preached like it needs to be preached. Amen. But there he is. Amen. Suffering, and all of a sudden,
God, have your way, Jesus.
Praise God.
He says this. It is finished. Now I want to point something out to you.
The sacrifice all the way up to that point has been exposed. Y'all see what I'm talking about? The shears. Here he is, Bruce, all his life, he's been making his way to that cross. Y'all see what I'm talking about? All them days he walked. The woman at the well, the man at the pool of Bethesda. Amen. Come on now. All the people that he touched, the blind that he made, see, he was exposing God. Amen. As the Lamb of God. Amen. There he was, the Lamb of God. Amen. On that cross. Amen. And then he said, amen, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Amen. And he said, amen, he gave up the ghost. Amen. And then behold, all right, the lamb phase has come to an end. And verse 51 says, and behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from top to the bottom, and the earth did shake and the rocks did rend. Amen. With the Lamb of God, amen, when he told him in the 15th chapter of John, amen, that I must go away, that another should come. Amen. Praise God. Amen. He was going away. Amen. That new thing could come, Uncle Larry. Amen. That thing, amen, that he sent. Amen. Into the upper room, glory to God. Amen. And his initial outpouring. Amen. Upon the disciples. Amen. He said they clove in tongues of fire. Amen. Set upon their heads. Yeah. Amen. And they came out. And they spoke the word of God with boldness. Amen. I want you to know something tonight. Amen. God pulled the curtain back. Amen. So that we could see. Amen. That could have been hid. Amen. I'm talking about it over time. Amen. The power of God manifested itself inside of the church. Amen. God. Amen. Pulled back the curtain. Amen. And you know what he said? Amen. I give my son. Amen. Whosoever believeth on him, amen, should not perish. But I pull back the curtain. Amen. So that you can see my glory. Amen. Amen. So that you can see my power.
Amen. Amen.
Bless
the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
He pulled it back. See, listen. Before God rent the curtain, there'd be a curtain across you. Amen.
Amen.
What is our power in 2015? Prayer. Prayer.
Amen.
What is our power in 2015? Amen. Our power, amen, is we're not behind the curtain anymore. Amen. Glory to God. God's tore that curtain down. Amen. We got access to the altar of God. Amen. Amen. God said, I'm going to pull it back so you can see.
Amen.
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 He manifested himself, amen, through all 28 miracles that Jesus performed in the New Testament. He exposed himself, amen, from life to death. He said, listen, amen. You know what he said? But Lord, he's been there 4 days. He's stinking. He's been there. He's starting to rot. Oh, we can't roll that stone back. Amen. If thou wouldest believe, thou shalt see the glory of God. Amen. He said, I am the resurrection. Amen. God's pulled back the curtain. Amen. No longer is the Lamb of God. Amen. Walking this earth with us. Amen. He's walking this earth inside of us. Amen. Filling us up. Amen. We got access to the altar. Amen. We can make God move.
Amen.
Amen. Do you got the faith to move God tonight? I'm talking about the same God that I preach that created everything. You know, science has brought us so far, Brother Adam. And we see so many things that they can do now. They can transplant organs. It ain't took about 2,000 years
amen, to figure out, amen, how God, amen, created this body. Come on now. They can transplant it, amen, they can grow, amen, ears, they can make skin, they can do all of these things. They can take a heart out, put another one in, amen, a liver, amen, all of these things they can transplant, amen, but the one thing, amen, God, amen, has not allowed them to be able to transplant, amen, and that's your soul, amen, but God said tonight, amen, I pulled the curtain back, amen, it was ripped up to the bottom, amen, I made myself, amen, open to you, amen, and the power of me, amen, is inside of you, all you got to do is
amen.
He showed himself to him. He pulled the curtain back.
Amen.
How many of you know that? And I believe this. God tore that curtain.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You see, it used to be, amen, that the priests and all them people, amen, Brother Ronnie, they had a stranglehold. And they said, who could and who can't? Amen. But God said, I so love this world that I gave my only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe upon his name, amen, praise God, amen, should not have to perish, but can have everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen.
God pulled back the curtain. Everything's been exposed. His power, his love, his mercy, his grace, everything. Amen. We got the power of his love. We got the power of his mercy. Amen. We got the power, amen, Brother Ralph. Amen. To lay hands on the sick. Amen. Through the stripes that he took upon his back. Amen. We got a power, amen, tonight. Amen. To speak to that mountain, be God removed. And it's got to remove henceforth. I want you to know something tonight. Amen. God pulled back the curtain.
Yes.
Amen.
He exposed himself.
Amen.
To me and you.
Is God hid in the closet?
No.
Is God hid behind the curtain anymore?
No. The fullness.
Amen of him. And so many times I've read that scripture and I think about what Paul wrote. I have not seen nor ever heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man the things God hath in store for them that love him. 1 Corinthians 2:9, verse 10 says, yea, but the deep things of God, yea, the deep things of God hath been revealed unto us by his Spirit.
Amen.
I've never seen the streets of gold, amen, but praise God, I know they're there.
Amen.
Come on now.
Amen.
I never seen God sitting on the throne, amen, with the man child, amen, on the Isle of Patmos, amen, on the Lord's day. Amen. A vision, amen. He was carried up in the Spirit. Amen. He was shown these things, Brother Ronnie. Amen. He seen him sitting on the throne. Amen. Feet like brass. Amen. It had been brazen in the fire. Amen. Hair like wool. Amen. Eyes of the flame of fire. Amen. Praise God. I believe. Amen. He's there. I believe he's high and lifted up. Amen. I believe the angels are flying around his throne. Amen. From north, south, east, and west. Amen. Praise him. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory, glory, glory. Amen. Praise God. Amen. But in the 19th chapter of the book of Revelation, amen, it says that there's a numberless multitude. Amen. Standing before the throne. Amen. And a voice comes out from the throne. Amen. Say it all. Amen. Say hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. I want to be there. Amen. I want to be a part of it. Amen. He ain't withheld nothing from us.
Amen.
He opened the curtain and revealed himself to us.
Amen.
What are we waiting on? What are we waiting on? Amen. We waiting on the right song. Amen.
I like that part of that song, April. You sang that song and said, I can hear the sound of the chains.
Come on now. I'm talking about Paul. Amen. Silas in jail. Amen. Beat for preaching the word of God. Amen. There they are. Amen. Stocks. Amen. they praise and sing, amen. And all of a sudden, glory to God, hallelujah, amen. Nobody with a key comes in, amen, but the power of God manifests itself, amen. And they sang it and lifted up the name, amen, of the only begotten, amen, of the Lord, amen, our Father, amen, Jesus Christ, amen. And all of a sudden, amen, them chains that had fell down, amen, fell to the ground, amen. Glory to God, the door swung open, amen. But they had so much victory, they didn't even have to leave. Praise God.
Praise God.
That centurion running there. Lord, have mercy. What's going on? Paul said, listen, do yourself no harm. But we're here. Praise God. Amen. Wasn't all worth it. You listen. Amen. As they went, amen, to that Philippian jailer's house and ministered to him. Amen. And he found the Lord. Come on now. Was it worth it? Oh, listen. Would any of us take a whipping, amen, to see somebody saved? Amen. Paul took a bunch out. Amen. He was stoned. He was whipped. Amen. Was it worth it? That not only that jailer found the Lord, amen, but glory to God, his whole house. Amen. What am I talking about tonight? Amen. The curtain's been pulled open. Yes. Amen. God said, I'm here. Amen. Won't you come and taste? You ain't got to have no money. Amen.
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 You're going to have to. I won't use any of the references I've used in the past about neighborhoods and stuff. Some people take offense to that. But I can promise you I've never meant any harm. All I've tried to do is tell you that it don't matter whether you're black, white, big, short, tall, or fat like me. God loves you.
Amen.
He wants you. The world may say we don't want you. But God says, I want you. Hey, listen. Jesus said, I want you. I paid a price. Greater love for no man than he laid down his life for his friend. I call you not a servant, but a friend, because the servant knoweth not what the master doeth. Everything I know of the Father, I have revealed it unto you. John 15. Amen. I'm here tonight to tell you, God, open the curtain. Stand with the teeth. We know it. Amen. That's all I got. In them scriptures, Jesus, he opened himself up and he opened the Father up. But in that 51st verse, as he gives up the ghost, and the word says, and behold, the veil of the temple was rent from it. All that that he suffered for, all of that, pay attention, came down.
The one thing, D. He opened himself up. He opened up the Holy of Holies to me and you. So tonight, if you got something that's hindering you, or something you've been praying about, God said tonight, I'm going to open the curtain. I'm opening the curtain. Come to my altar. Altar tonight, you come to this altar. If you need to come to this altar for strength,
it ain't the only thing you come to the altar for is to repent. Come to this altar, amen, and look for some power. Come to this altar and look for more than what you got. You don't mean you're a sinner every time you come to the altar. You don't know Jesus Christ tonight as your personal Savior. Friend, let me tell you something you can't get into heaven without him. No one cometh unto the Father but by me.